By now, we learned how to work with get items. Now we want to go to get item and we want to see what this one can offer. Get items was mainly like get it all or give me the subset of the records that meet some certain criteria. While get item is the exact opposite. Get item does not search. Get item does not filter. For the get item, you have to have one specific item in mind and go straight to that and pick it up. In better word, get item does not search. Get item takes your request for a specific item. If it is there, it returns it. If it's not there, it gives you an error. So in summary, get item returns only one item based on the ID. And that's exactly the same thing inside SharePoint or any other data provider. Assuming that you have an ID that uniquely identifies every single item. Get item returns all the item properties, while get items doesn't. For example, if you have a list item and you want to get the attachments of it, get items doesn't give you that. So you may want to use the get items to get all the items that have some certain criteria. But if you want to, for example, get the attachments or some specific properties, now you have to pass these IDs one by one to get item and get them all. Get item is much faster than get items, obvious because it doesn't really search. So the bottom line is, if you have item ID, you use get item. If you don't have the ID, you have to search for the items with the get items, and after that, use the ID to do anything else that you want with it. Let's see it in action. Just like before, I go to flow.microsoft.com, I click on create, and I want to create a new flow. This one again is going to be an instant flow, and I want to call it get item demo. I manually trigger a flow and I click on create. When the flow is created, let's assume that I want to use the manually trigger a flow to accept one parameter, and that parameter is going to be a number or text, doesn't matter. I call it a number, and that number is going to be item ID. And that's it. So when I get the item ID, I want to pass it to SharePoint and get the details of that item and send it to my mailbox. I click on new step and I search for SharePoint. Click on SharePoint, and this time I'm looking for get item. I click on get item, and just like before, I need to look up the site that I want to use. It was Power Automate Workshop. The list name that I was using was products list demo. And the ID is what I'm going to get from manually trigger a flow, which is the item ID. Now, get item has a lot more to offer. So if I click on show advanced options, you will see limit columns by view. So avoid column threshold issues by only using the columns defined in a view. So basically, if you go inside SharePoint and SharePoint has a default view, get item only returns us the columns that are in the view. While actually we can override it and say use all columns. So this one literally returns everything that we want. Then I click on save. And after that, let's say new step, I would say email, Office 365 Outlook, and I want to say send an email V2. Again, I want to send it to myself, and the subject is going to be product, and in front of it, I want to put the ID. And the ID is coming from either here, or we can get it from manually trigger flow. They both have the same thing. So basically, if I can use the item ID, I'm getting it directly from the manually trigger flow. Now I can go to the message body and I say product name. And for this one, maybe I put the title here. But now if you go and take a look at the get item, you see the list is massive. It has a lot more columns than what you had before. So anyway, I just say, for example, unit price, just like before. And here I search for unit price. Maybe again, category. And I'm looking for category value. And finally, I want to say who last modified. So last updated by, and I'm searching for modified by display name. Save and let's run test and see how it works. Test, continue, run flow, and it says you need to provide a product ID. Let me go back to my SharePoint. And inside SharePoint, I can simply add the ID column, show hide columns. ID is hidden by default. So I just also want to put it a bit higher as the first item. So we have ID, title, category, and unit price now. And I say apply. So now I have the ID. I'm looking for product ID number 4, for example. So if I enter 4 here, and if I click on run flow, done, and it's successfully done. Let's go to my mailbox and see what I got. And here is the email that has Rubik's Cube, unit price 35, category, and last updated by. And this ends the get items and get items. So basically how we can retrieve records from a certain data source. Now it's time to deal with update and delete.